featuring Mackenzie.
Let's go.
Welcome back to Game Squad. We're about to continue the game. Can we load?
No.
Time to start a new one.
I both hate and love these games that fuck with you.
It's an ordinary school day like any other. As usual, I'm surrounded by couples and friend groups walking to school together. I always tell myself it's about time I meet some girls or something like that.
Hey, Dario!
She's back!
Well, there already is one girl. That girl's Sayori, my neighbor and good friend since we were children. She's no longer that annoying girl.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We used to walk to school together every day. And recently, we've picked up that habit once again.
She's not oversleeping anymore.
Dariel, are you proud of me?
Eh, for what?
You know, for waking up on time.
Well, you've been doing that for a while now.
Uh-huh. But you never even said anything about it. Even though we walk to school together every day.
Well, yeah. I always thought it was implied.
You stupid bitch.
You stupid bitch. It's embarrassing to say out loud.
Come on, please. It's good motivation.
Fine. I'm proud of you, Sayori.
Say it in a nice voice.
Can you get me some chili dogs?
Say it in a nice voice.
I'm proud of you, Sayori.
Thank you.
We cross the street together and make our way to school. As we draw near, the streets become increasingly speckled with other students making their daily commute.
By the way, Dariel, have you decided on a club to join yet?
A club? I told you already, I'm really not... I start to say what I always do, that I'm not interested in joining any clubs. But something tells me Sayori would take more offense to that now. After all, how could I tell her that clubs are a waste of time, when she's starting a club of her very own? Actually, yeah, I think I've decided on a club.
Really? Which one? Tell me!
I think I'll keep it a surprise.
Boo. You meanie.
Be patient. You'll find out soon enough. I used to ask myself why I let myself get lectured by such a carefree girl. But I started to realize that in a way, I envy her. When Sayori puts her mind to something, she can accomplish great things. So that's why I feel like I should do something special for her. The school day is as ordinary as ever, and it's over before I know it. After I pack up my things, I stand up, gathering my motivation. Let's see. I recall the room number of the club from a flyer I saw. I walk across the school and upstairs, a section of the school I rarely visit, being generally used for third-year classes and activities. Before long, I find the room. I timidly open the door in front of me. Hello?
Dariel? What are you doing here?
Well, I just... I glance around the room.
Huh. So you're the Dariel that Sayori's always talking about.
Thank you for stopping by.
Yuri!
Yay!
It's a pleasure to meet
nice
you,
nice to see you not dead.
And not fucking nuts.
Yeah.
We're the Literature Club. I hope you enjoy your visit.
She's so sweet. Come on, Yuri. No need to be so formal. He's gonna think we're really strict or something.
Sorry, Natsuki.
The tall one, whose name is apparently Yuri, seems to be quite shy compared to the others. In comparison, the girl named Natsuki, despite her size, seems like the assertive one. Well, it's nice to meet both of you. You know, the beginning part of this game would have been a lot less dickish if I had been using a normal voice.
Yeah.
So I was right, it was my voice.
It was your voice.
You're calling Dariel an asshole. He's not.
Well, did call Sayori annoying. And
that dummy.
I look forward to working with you. Well, yeah. Dummy is teasing.
Well, it depends. Working? Dariel, don't tell me. You're...
That's right. The club I've decided to join is yours, Sayori. The Literature Club. Sayori's eyes light up.
No way!
Sayori wraps her arms around me, jumping up and down. Hey.
Well, if Sayori is this happy, then I'm sure it won't be so bad to have you around.
Not to mention there's four of us now. That means we can become an officially recognized club.
I don't know what to say. I have to celebrate.
What an appropriate day for that, isn't it?
Yeah. After all, Natsuki decided to...
Hey, don't ruin the surprise.
Sorry.
Everyone sit down at the table, okay?
How about I make some tea as well?
The girls have a few desks arranged to form a table. Natsuki and Yuri walk over to the corner of the room where Natsuki grabs a wrapped tray and Yuri opens the closet. Still feeling awkward, I take a seat next to Sayori.
I love this.
Atsuki proudly marches back to the table, tray in hand.
Okay, are you ready? Ta-da!
Natsuki lifts the foil off the tray to reveal a dozen white fluffy cupcakes decorated to look like little cats.
Natsuki lifts the foil off the tray to reveal a gun. Oh my law.
Mushine.
Nani? The Sayori just, Nani?
Nani? Bean.
The whiskers are drawn with icing and little pieces of chocolate were used to make ears. We've already had this conversation, and we are going to.
I forgot.
Game Squad,
so cute!
Game Squad, wow, those look amazing.
Well, you know...
Not as amazing as she does,
fuck
so.
Off!
Well,
just hurry and take
gotta
one.
Get fast.
I hate you.
Just hurry and take one.
Sayori grabs one first, then I follow.
It's delicious!
Sayori talks with her mouth full and has already managed to get icing on her face. I turn the cupcake around in my fingers, looking for the best angle to take a bite. Natsuki is quiet. I can't help but notice her sneaking glances in my direction. Is she waiting for me to take a bite? I finally bite down. The icing is sweet and full of flavor. I wonder if she made it herself. This is really good. What did you just do?
You said it's full of flavor, so I just went...
Right next to my ear.
Do that next to the mic so they can know too.
Oh, wait. No, I got one better for you.
Oh, no!
Yes! Thank you, Natsuki.
She just starts doing that right next to you.
Of course
we missed it.
Oh no!
Oh no! I'll just make it myself.
Nice. I'm a pro. That's you.
Well,
excuse you.
I'm sorry. You've done it too.
I've done it so much. I'm a pro after all.
I'm pretty good at reading.
There's no need to thank me or anything. I'm bad at it.
As Natsuki struggles to accept the compliment, Yuri returns to the table carrying a tea set. She carefully places a teacup in front of each of us before setting down the teapot next to the cupcake tray. You keep a whole tea set in this classroom?
Don't worry, the teachers gave us permission. After all, doesn't a hot cup of tea help you enjoy a good book?
No.
I guess.
Already trying to impress our new member, Yuri.
Uh-huh. That's not...
Insulted, Yuri looks away.
I meant that, you know.
I believe you. Well, tea and reading might not be a pastime for me, but I at least enjoy tea.
I'm glad.
Yuri faintly smiles to herself in relief.
So, Dariel, what kinds of things do you like to read?
Well, considering how little I've read these past few years, I don't really have a good way of answering that. Manga. I mutter quietly to myself, half-joking. Natsuki's head suddenly perks up! Looks like she must say something, but she keeps quiet.
Not much of a reader, I guess.
Well, that can change. What am I saying? I spoke without thinking after seeing Yuri's sad smile. Anyway, what about you, Yuri?
Well, let's see.
Yuri traces the rim of her teacup with her finger.
My favorites are usually novels that build deep and complex fantasy worlds.
Also,
the level of creativity and craftsmanship behind them is amazing to me. And telling a good story in such a foreign world is equally as impressive.
Yuri goes on, clearly passionate about her reading. She seems so reserved and timid since the moment I walked in, but it's obvious by the way her eyes light up that she finds her comfort in the world of books, not people.
But you know, I like a lot of things. Don't feel intimidated if you don't read much, okay? I'm sure we can find something that we have in common.
Hey, Yuri.
Huh?
Well, about, you know, the first thing he said.
Manga?
That's right. Natsuki tends to read manga in the club room.
Don't just say it!
For some reason, Natsuki seems embarrassed about it.
Besides, manga is literature too, you know? So if Dariel wants to read some of my manga, then don't try to stop him or anything.
Natsuki, I wouldn't do such a thing. However, it could also be nice for us to diversify ourselves a little. He can take this opportunity to try something new as well. Wouldn't you agree, Dariel?
Maybe...
Sensing the tension, Sayori jumps in.
Maybe we can all try something new. I think it could be fun. And we'll all get to know each other a little bit better, too. I mean, that's the kind of thing literature clubs do, right?
Ellipses. I don't disagree or anything.
Yeah. You're right as usual, President. Guess that means I should try picking up a novel or something, huh?
Well, that would make two of us. I wouldn't mind doing it if I'm not the only one.
Then, as for Yuri...
I have to read manga?
Jeez. You were the one who suggested we diversify. You should be a little more open-minded. It's kind of hurtful.
Hurtful? I didn't realize.
This is going so much better.
Right?
Without Monica here, it honestly goes well.
It's almost strangely well. Mm-hmm. With a guilty expression, Yuri thinks to herself.
I'm sorry for disrespecting your interests, Natsuki. If you're into it, then I'm sure it's a worthy form of literature.
It's great that they're such great friends.
I love it. Are you just saying that?
No. I've realized my error. So, if you're willing to consider starting a novel, then I'll offer my gratitude by finding a manga to read as well.
Really? I... Grab the damn water bottle. I mean, it makes me happy that you do that for me, Yuri.
Sorry.
You can trust me to find something that you'll really like, okay?
Same here. Perhaps I'll visit the bookstore after the club meeting.
Just you?
Would you like to come along with me?
if you don't mind.
Not at all. I always go alone, so...
Yeah, me too. This is so cute!
Sayori, shut up!
I'll show you some manga there too, okay?
Yes. I look forward to it.
Damn it.
Natsuki and Yuri start to clean up the food.
I guess the meeting's over, huh?
Yeah, it looks like it. It's nice to see everyone getting along.
Isn't it? I think everyone likes you too, Dariel.
You think so? Well, everyone always seems to get along a little better with you around, Sayori.
Yup.
Aw, Dariel! Don't say something like that, it's embarrassing!
Well, whatever. I was surprised when you told me you were starting a club. But I think you're pulling off just fine.
We're gonna make it the best club ever! Now that you've joined, every day is gonna be so much fun! Hey, Dariel, I really want to thank you. I mean, I'm really happy that you joined the club and everything, but the truth is, I already knew you were going to-
Fuck. God damn it.
There's actually something else. I wanted to thank you for getting rid of Monica.
Fuck.
That's right.
It was fucking Sayori.
I know everything that she did. Maybe it's because I'm the president now.
God damn it.
But I really know everything, Dariel. I know how hard you tried to make everyone happy. I know about all the awful things that Monica did just to make everyone sad. But none of that matters anymore. It's just us now.
Fuck!
You want to make me the happiest girl in the whole world. I can't wait to spend every day like this. With you. Forever and ever. F-O-R-E-V-E-R.
No.
You know who this is?
Monica.
Yes.
Eh? What's happening?
I won't let you hurt him.
God damn it, Monica.
Who? It hurts!
I'm sorry. I was wrong. There's no happiness here after all. Goodbye, Sayori. Goodbye, Dariel. Goodbye, Literature Club.
Dude,
there's God! I saw God! I saw God. How pleasant.
Can you hear me? Hi, it's me. So, you know how I've been, like, practicing piano and stuff? And not really any good at it yet. Like, at all. But I wrote you a song, and I was kind of hoping that I could show it to you, because I worked really, really hard on it. So, yeah.
So good!
assignment to do today. When you're here, everything that we do is fun for them anyway.
I never really saw them at
school. No, no, we did.
When I can't even
we did.
My own fears. What good or worse? When a smile says
no,
it all.
No, it's the ones that are colored.
And if this world won't write me an ending, what will it take just for me to have it all?
Oh, we saw that.
We saw that. That's okay.
Bam.
We didn't see that, Yuri.
Jillian
Ashcraft is really good.
There's, yeah.
Does my pen only write better words for those who are dear to me?
You saw that, Sayori.
Oh, hi, Sayori.
Is it love? If I take your is it love? If I set you free?
Springtime. Oh, goddammit. Why are they moving?
The ink flows down into a dark puddle. How can I write?
Back when I thought love was real!
Yeah.
If I can't hear the sound of your heartbeat, what do you call love in your reality? And in your reality, if I don't know how to love you, I'll leave you be.
Yay!
No.
Kim Salvato cover.
This is my final goodbye to the Literature Club. I finally understand. The Literature Club is truly a place where no happiness can be found. To the very end, it continued to expose innocent minds to a horrific reality. A reality that our world is not designed to comprehend. I can't let any of my friends undergo that same hellish epiphany. For the time it lasted, I want to thank you. For making all of my dreams come true. For being a friend to all of the club members. And most of all, thank you for being a part of my Literature Club. With everlasting love, Monica.
So there's technically... So this is the ending of the game. There's technically...
Error, script file is missing or corrupt. Please reinstall the game.
There's and technically a true ending.
Mm-hmm.
Where you see all of the different pictures.
Mm-hmm.
That's the...
No!
Condition. I almost... it was close.
You would have to redo everything.
Oh, God. Anyways, there's a true ending that what?
Well... I forget what happens, but if you get all the pictures,
you get a,
like,
special thing.
It says something special.
Nice.
Yep. So, what did you think?
Jordan, throw up a DokiCast graphic.
A what graphic?
A DokiCast. It's
Doki
the Doki podcast.
Oh.
Yay.
Yay.
So, but it was good, right?
It was good. It hurt me, but it was good.
And it was beautifully...
I'm really sad.
It was very good.
I'm really sad now.
I think it was
and
good.
Like,
I just wanted to make him happy, and you can't...
Well, yeah, but, you know.
I just wanted them to be happy.
And the Monica character, really, it's...
It was actually pretty neat.
The Monica
cool
character is tragic.
Mm-hmm. It is tragic.
She actually says some really interesting things if you talk to her, but we didn't have time. I actually like the Monica character.
I tried to put
off the vibe of not liking her, but she's good.
I disliked her.
Sayori is still my favorite.
Sayori is my favorite, so I disliked her because she fucked up her friends. But
Monica is actually my favorite.
She didn't actually delete them, so now I like her. And she's okay. She's okay in my books.
So Sayori...
Sayori is my favorite. Sayori is my favorite.
Alrighty. Well,
I'm glad that you enjoyed it, but now it's time for us to go.
I think there's only one way to end this video.
There is.
It's a tribute to our favorite tsundere. Adios.